Diode in an application. And our application, the first one we do is half-wave rectifier. So we have a transformer with a primary and a secondary windings, and you all know that that current is induced from primary to secondary because you all did electrical engineering. Then we've got one diode and a load resistance. Now, remember when we did the diode, when we put the positive and the negative piece of material together, we had a depletion layer, and when we forward bias, the diode acted like a switch, it came on, current flowed, and we were okay. And the reverse bias, we know that the diode switches off, no current flow. Right, so what happens here? There's my input, is a sine wave. So on the first half cycle, we have a positive cycle. So we have positive, negative. So if we have positive, negative, this diode is positive on positive, negative on negative, and my diode is forward biased. Let me just admit again. So with the diode that is forward biased, I will get current flow on the output, and I will get out what I put in, except for 0.7 volts that falls over the diode when it is forward biased. When I look at my negative half cycle, I will now have a negative half cycle. I will have negative, positive. My diode is reverse biased. No current flow can flow in the secondary, which means that no output waveform. And again, with my next positive cycle, I will have an output again. So, hence the half wave rectification. One half wave rectify, one half wave off, one half wave rectify, one half wave off. And that is our first start to using the diode. Now, what for about the full wave? And we will sort of start with full wave rectification, center tap. How do I know it is center tap? I have my primary windings and my secondary windings. Now, if you look at your secondary windings, and in the center, you have an earth, a ground. This is the reason why it is called center tapped. So your input will be induced from your primary to your secondary. And because it is a center tap, this half will receive V secondary over 2, and this half will receive V secondary over 2. 180 degrees out of phase. Right. So, what do we see here? Is this now full wave or half wave? Half wave, we know only one cycle gets to the output. So let's have a look here. In our positive half cycle, I have on my secondary, I have positive, positive, negative. I have negative, negative, positive, which means because of these two halves, 180 degree out of phase, only one diode will switch on at a time. So for the positive half cycle, this diode is forward biased. This one is reverse bias.
And because I have a diode that is forward bias, I will have an output waveform.
My next cycle, on my negative cycle, I will get negative cycle over here, which means negative positive across this diode. This diode switches off. And on the negative cycle, I have positive, positive, negative. This diode switches on.
And again, because I have a diode that is switched on, I have an output waveform.
And as you can see, I have input, output, 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 output. Positive cycle, negative cycle, both cycles, I have an output. Therefore, that is called a full wave. If we look back at the half wave, what is the frequency? The frequency is one cycle. And in this case, this is also one cycle. So your frequency of your input and your output is exactly the same. But look at your full wave. This is a normal cycle, which means this is your frequency that you put in. What do I get out? I get a cycle and a cycle. For the same frequency, input frequency, I get double cycle at the output, which means my frequency doubles at the output. So if your frequency is 50 hertz at the input, it will be 100 hertz at the output. Why do I say 50 hertz? We are in South Africa. Eskom supply us with 50 hertz, 220 volts. America, your textbooks, they get 110 volts, 60 hertz. If I do not give you a frequency, you immediately assume, because we are in South Africa, you use 50 hertz. So you always know that the input frequency has got 50 hertz. Now you have to determine what is your output frequency. Now your output frequency for half wave is also 50 hertz, but your output frequency for a full wave will be 100 hertz. Now, what I have picked up in the past, the moment students see a transformer at the input, they assume, when they see two diodes, they assume it is a center tap. This one is not a center tap. This is a normal transformer with two diodes. Look at your diodes. They're not facing the same way. I want a full wave. Then if I have a positive cycle, this one switches on and give me an output. This one is reverse bias. So this will switch off. Negative cycle, this one is reverse bias. This one is forward bias and I will have an output. Which means that no earth. So everything, your secondary, is over this one, minus comma seven, because there's only one diode working at a time, and you still have your full wave rectification. Right, we have another type of full wave rectification, and we call it a bridge full wave rectifier. This is the type that you will normally see in your instruments at the input, where you have your normal 220 volt supply here, and you get your primary and your secondary windings, which will then reduce the voltage. Then you will get your four diodes. Diode 1, diode 2, diode 3, diode 4. Now, yeah, two diodes work together at a time. Do not confuse yourselves. If it is the positive cycle, this point is positive, this point is negative. Do not look any further than this. This point is positive, this point is negative. If this point is positive, this diode will switch on. This diode with the negative here will switch on, which means that there will be current flow from here through diode 1, through my load, up through diode 2, up to my input, back to my input. So I will have current flow in this direction through my load. That is for the positive cycle. Diode 1 and diode 2 works together. The opposite diodes work together. If I look at my negative cycle, I now have negative there, positive here. With a negative here, this diode will switch on. With a positive here, this diode will switch on. And I will have current, positive and negative, current, up. And again, if I work from positive to negative, my current will flow in this direction. So, for a full wave rectifier, a full wave bridge rectifier, we now have two diodes that work together, which means my output, what I put in the peak, my output, I will have to deduct 0.7 and 0.7, 1.4 volts, because I have two diodes that work together. So look here, so my output will be the V primary at the second, the voltage at the secondary point, the peak voltage, minus 1.4, because it's 0.7 plus 0.7. What's the 0.7? That is the voltage over the depletion layer when this diode is forward biased. Right, that won't change. It's a constant 0.7. We have established that in the last lesson. Now, I don't want this waveforms like it is like that. This is just a rectified AC. Because what are these circuits doing? They are changing AC to DC. Now we all know DC is a flat straight line. This is not a flat straight line. So I want to attempt to get it a straight line. We will never get it a total straight line, but we can get very close. How do we do it? We use filters. And a filter, in this case, what we work with is a capacitor. If you look at this normal half-wave cycle, for positive cycle, your diode switches on. This capacitor charges positive, negative, and current goes through the load. On your negative half cycle, there is no current going through the load. The diode doesn't switch on, but because there is now a positive, a negative on this side, and a positive on this side, the capacitor will discharge. So it will discharge, it will charge until maximum positive, then it will discharge
until the next positive cycle starts up again.
So we will have this kind of zigzag type of circuit. Full wave, exactly the same thing. If we look at the bridge rectifier circuit, we do the normal bridge. The current goes through two diodes at a time, either one and two, or three and four, and we get our rectified DC. Our rectified DC is at this point, just after the bridge, just after it goes through the diode. Now we have a capacitor that will charge until the positive, and when the cycle goes down, the cap will stop discharging until the positive is here again. So it will charge, discharge, charge, discharge. What does it look like? It looks like a nearly a straight line. When we enlarge the waveform, we see this. We see this, and this little part will be my peak-to-peak ripple, and that is what we see as DC. Where do we measure? The center of this ripple to ground gives me the DC voltage. So now I have attempted to change AC into DC and to make it nearly a straight line like DC is. I use capacitor to charge and discharge, and I will get a DC voltage out. There's your DC voltage, 1 minus 1 over 2 frequency RLC, your ripple peak to peak, and this circuit is when we regulate. What means regulate? Regulate means I want a specific output. I want the output of 15 volts. That's it. Nothing more, nothing less. 15 volts. Then I use my normal AC to DC rectification. I use my normal capacitor to give my DC levels with a little ripple. Then my voltage regulator must be a 15 volt voltage regulator, so that here at the output I get 15 volts out. Immaterial what I get here. I want at the output, I want 15 volts out. So if I get 20 volts out here, it will be flattened to 15 volt here. And this is how far we come today. This is still chapter 2. And this is still work that you relatively have no problem in understanding. Please remember to ask questions if you have a problem, especially if you get different answers than in the book. The book is full of mistakes. Just check with me if your answer that you get is correct. I had two questions of students that asked me, and their calculations were correct where the book was incorrect. So please check. If you get a different answer than in the book, don't assume that you are wrong. You might be right. And this is how far that we go. I can't remember what is else, if we have something else in chapter 2. But I need to spend time with you on the Zener diodes. Diode limiting. That's what we're doing next. And I need to spend some time, and you need to understand that, because limiting and clamping, those are the two parts that is the most difficult in electronics 1 for students. And we will take time to go through that. Therefore, this work where students have no problems understanding, we go past and through it a bit quicker. Please note again, I did not do everything. The things that I skip, the onus is on you to do that. There's lots of theoretical things in between here that I skip. You can all read, therefore you can all study theory. And that is it for today. Any questions? Test, I will give you the scope of the test, hopefully later tonight, for Friday's test. And if you clash with another subject, like physics or so, you can write the rewrite on Monday. Any questions?
Then I am done. Thank you guys. Bye.